Haha, you doing everybody? It's me, your boy. So, Minecraft, it has four different types of armor protection enchantments. Projectile protection, fire protection, blast protection, and just standard plain old protection. That's nice and all, everybody knew that, but which one is best? Well, today we're going to run a couple different tests to find out. If you enjoyed today's video, smash like. If you have another question that needs answering, drop it down in the comments below and subscribe. 1000K, let's go. Before we run our tests, we should probably get a couple things out of the way. Thing number one, keep in mind that every single type of protection has four levels, so fire protection 1, 2, 3, and 4. Today we're looking for the best protection and also the best armor set in the game, which means we can ignore all of the lower levels. All we'll be looking at today is level 4 of every single protection enchantment. I've set up a couple different tests. These tests will help us figure things out. Each test showcases what each protection does perfectly. Now, if you didn't know, protection, it actually maxes out eventually. We'll talk a little bit more about that, though, later on in the video. We're going to run three tests for every type of protection. In test number one, every single time, we'll use one piece of plain old unenchanted iron armor. In the second test, we'll actually level things up. We'll get protection 4 of whatever type of protection we're testing and put it on one piece of armor. Finally, in the third test, we'll put two pieces of protection 4 armor on. Finally, one last thing to get out of the way, it doesn't matter where the protection 4 is. If it's on a helmet, if it's on a chestplate, it's going to do the same exact thing. Fire protection 4 helmet, jump into the lava, we take a little bit of damage. Jump out of the lava, take that off, heal up, assuming everything is identical, like exactly identical, health, everything like that, we will take the same amount of damage. Blast protection, you know, explosions. If you have problems with creepers, maybe if you tend to stand on top of TNT when you blow it up, maybe you try and sleep in the nether, blast protection is probably your type of protection. In test number one, I've set up a blast proof chamber. All we're going to do is put the armor on and stand right next to the creeper. The creeper will realize I'm there, freak out, blow up, you know, that type of thing. So, test number one, our health is currently full. We have one iron chestplate on, that's it. Now, we flip into survival mode, look at the creeper, and that happens. Yep, to be expected. That is never good. Alright, now, we'll put a creeper back in there. There we go. Swap over to a blast protection 4 chestplate. Now, surprisingly, I don't think we're going to survive this. Yep, way too close to the creeper. But, I think if we were to level things up just a little bit more, we should probably be good. So, blast protection 4, two pieces of it. Creeper, hello creeper. And there we go. We survive the explosion. We get sent way up into the air. We land back down, but we've successfully survived the explosion. Two pieces of blast protection, and we can survive a creeper that's right on top of us. When that other update dropped, fire protection was my boy. Fire protection helps protect the player against fire damage. Pretty predictable. So, iron chestplate, pit of lava right here. We fell in the lava. Oh no, this is bad. We stand in the lava for a little while. We take quite a bit of fire damage. Lava is definitely very, very dangerous. Now, we need to heal up. Successfully heal up all the way, and now it's enchantment time. Now, surprisingly, with fire protection 4, you'll do well. You would have a little bit of time to get out of the lava, but definitely not as well as one would probably expect. Fire protection 4, one piece of armor, that's not very fire protection. Not at all, actually. But if we can manage to step things up a little bit and get two pieces of fire protection 4 armor, then, actually, things get a whole lot better. So, two pieces of fire protection, 4 armor, and we can basically just stand in the lava and not really have to worry about it. I mean, we do have to worry about it, right? We can't sit in there forever. But we have a whole lot more time. So, fire protection 4, two pieces of it, is honestly significantly better than fire protection 4, one piece. So, two questions. Question number one, will the skeleton survive? I think it does. Question number two, will the skeleton be able to hit me? Next up is projectile protection. First, we need to get hit with an arrow when we only have iron armor on. We'll stand right against the fence gates back here. Perfect shot from Bone Boy. We took about a heart and a half of damage. Alright, so we're in the exact same spot still. I've healed up. Now it's time for projectile protection 4, the chest plate. So, any minute now? You failed. Okay, you try it again. You'll get it eventually. There we go. That time we took like a heart of damage. Almost nothing. Finally, it's time for protection 4 times 2. Two pieces of protection 4 armor does... Come on, you got this. You got this. You can do it. Yeah, right there. Look at that. Basically, no damage or literally no damage at all. Our chest plate and the leggings are going to take durability damage though. Keep that in mind. And finally, last but definitely not least, we have plain old protection. First, the unenchanted piece right here. You can give me. I know, yep, okay, little bit of damage. Adding a little bit of spice to things, protection 4, one piece of it, there we go. Seemingly the same amount of damage. Finally, gotta speed this one up, protection 4, two pieces of it, half a heart of damage, not much damage at all. So, actually, somewhat interestingly, based off of all of those tests right there, it seems that protection 4 might not be very good. I mean, the difference between unenchanted and one piece of protection 4 was not very significant, actually. Like, not at all. I took almost the same amount of damage, or literally the same exact amount of damage. Now, it's time to talk game statistics and how things actually work, because trust me, that is actually not the case here. But, big shout-out energy, EagleEye621. EagleEye621 has a super technical video on how all of this stuff works, the stuff that we're about to talk about. I have done my best to boil it down, make it a little bit more simple, but if you're into the super technical stuff, the information, the video is on point. Slide over there, send EagleEye621 some love, tell them I said hi. So the technical stuff. Let's say we had a pair of boots with fire protection 4 on it. If we had that pair of boots with fire protection 4 on it and we wore it, then we would have 8 points of fire protection. Now, in total, we can have 20 total enchantment points in each column, each section, before the cutoff. So right here, each block is a single point. This whole thing is our max, 20 total enchantment points. If we extend past it, it doesn't actually count anymore. Pair of leather boots, fire protection 4. Pair of leather pants, fire protection 4. Pair of leather chest plate, leather chest plate, fire protection 4. And you've passed all of these enchantment points by 4. You would have 24 fire protection points. The 4 points that have gone past this chart don't help you any extra. So 20 total enchantment points in each column. We have 3 columns, fire, blast, and projectile. For today's example, I'm also adding melee. That's an important type of damage to think about. So one piece of protection 4 armor grants you 8 points of whatever type of protection that is. You have 20 total points in each column. Now let's make everything a little bit more simple. We'll divide it all by 4. Fire protection 4, one piece of it, is going to give us 2 blocks on the smaller model. So right there, it all means exactly the same thing. I'm just compacting everything down. So now, leather boots, leather pants, leather chest plate, we still go past, leather helmet, all fire protection 4. We would actually have way more than enough fire protection. So that's going to be the same for blast protection and projectile protection, but not normal protection. Normal protection, protection 4, behaves a little bit differently. Protection 4 will give you 4 points to each column. So instead of 8 points in one column for these leather boots, we'll get 4 points of protection in fire, 4 in blast, 4 in projectile, and then 4 in melee. Again, in today's example. In the non-compressed version, this is what we'd be looking at right here. Leather boots fire protection 4 would be just this. Or leather boots protection 4, we would have this whole area filled in. We'd have a column for fire, blast, projectile, and then again, our example, melee over here. So we're gonna do the same thing. Divide that by 4, which means protection 4, one piece of it, gets 1 block in every single column. While again, one piece of protection 4 or anything else will give us 2 points in one column. It's a little bit confusing, technical, but stick with me. What armor set is best? As we know, we have 4 pieces of armor. Boots, pants, chest plate, and helmet. We need to figure out how we want to stack our points to create the best set of armor. Let's say we went with fire protection 4 boots. Then we'd have that right there, but protection from all other types of damage, it wouldn't happen. So we could continue to build out that fire protection 4 set with pants, a chest plate, and a helmet, and then we have way more than enough fire protection, but protection against nothing else. That's probably not very good. Same thing for every other type of protection. Blast protection, we could do the same thing. Projectile protection, we could do the same exact thing if we wanted to. Now, what about normal protection? Fire protection 4 boots, right there. Or protection 4 boots, right here. So check that out. Protection, it's going to help a little bit less with fire, but it's actually going to help with blast, projectile, and melee damage. So check this out right here. Boots protection 4, leggings protection 4, chest plate protection 4, and then finally, helmet protection 4. So we don't actually max out any column, but we have overall good protection against all damage types right there, including melee damage. Like you walk up to a zombie, you take damage. Alternatively, we could erase that and try and stack points around this table. Maybe 2 pieces of blast protection, a piece of fire protection, a piece of projectile protection, and look at that. This is what we have now. So we have a little bit of fire protection, a lot of bit of blast protection, a little bit of projectile protection, but anything gets up close to me and I'm done. No matter how you move these points around in this table, things will never be as good as 4 pieces of protection 4 armor. That's your answer right there. The best armor, protection 4 on everything. Of course, we have the other enchantments, like the helmet ones, the boot ones, but protection 4, when it comes to damage, is going to be best. So check this out. 1 piece of armor, maybe a 2nd piece of armor right there, a 3rd one right there, and a 4th one right there, and we're still not hitting this cap right here. If we try to stack things all in one column, so 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces right there, really good against blasts, but again, anything else, not good at all. Here's a good way to show this off. So check this out. This whole set of armor has fire protection 4. That's a lot of fire protection. In survival, we're gonna be fine in this. We're gonna take damage, but actually no, we're not gonna take any damage. So that's that. That's what that does. Now, let's go ahead and swap this out for actually a set of protection 4. Everything protection 4. If we jump into this fire here, we are actually going to take damage, but we're not. Then, eventually, after enough time, the damage will start to show. So a full set with fire protection 4 is clearly better, but protection 4 definitely, absolutely would do the job. So if you want overall the best set of armor, protection 4 on everything is probably the best. But let's say you want to specialize in something. So right here we have 3 pieces of armor on us with protection 4. It doesn't matter which 3. Then let's say, I don't know, for this example we live in the Nether. Maybe it would be a good idea to have a piece of armor with fire protection on it, because then our fire damage would be maxed out right there. We wouldn't get as much protection from the other 3 damage types, blasts, projectiles, and melee, but the fire would be really, really good, which is probably good to have in the Nether, honestly. And that idea could be translated really to anything else. Maybe you're doing a lot of caving, you could do blast protection piece of armor, or maybe you're dealing with like a lot of skeletons, skeleton farm, something like that, then maybe a projectile 4 piece wouldn't be a bad idea. Before the end of the video, 2 final things to mention. I hate to say it, but shields. Projectile shields. Yeah, shields can block pretty much all projectiles if you use them right, so maybe projectile protection 4 in general, like the whole enchantment, is not worth it. And when it comes to fire, we have the fire resistance potion. If you're into potion making, don't forget about the fire resistance potion. This is a good potion. With this potion, you can literally swim around in the lava. That's amazing, which also eliminates the purpose of fire resistance completely. If you have fire resistance on your armor, but you're just taking no lava damage at all, I mean, I have no armor on and I'm doing fine, so why would you need that on your armor? To conclude, the best armor in the game, the best protection type, is probably going to be protection, unless you're doing something very specific. If we had to rank every other protection, I would probably have to say blast protection, then fire protection, then finally projectile protection. Projectiles are pretty easy to handle with shields, and fire, you can handle that with fire resistance. Blast, I can't really think of a way to handle that though, so maybe blast protection isn't too bad. So that's it. If you enjoyed the video, help me out by leaving a like. It seriously helps big time, and if you're not subscribed, subscribe today. You'll get a new video in your sub feed every single day, and each video is spicier than the last one. Huge shout out to my patrons, Lord Zenera and Mr. PD Watch. Thank you so much. Thank you all for watching. Big announcement. New video tomorrow. I'll see you then. Goodbye.